जनरल स्टडीज पेपर टू टू क्वेश्चंस आर फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री. वन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, इवाल्युएट द पॉलिसीज ऑफ लॉर्ड कर्जन एंड देयर लॉन्ग टर्म इम्प्लिकेशन ऑन द नेशनल मूवमेंट. द क्वेश्चन कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू पार्ट. वन इज यू हैव टू राइट द पॉलिसीज एंड द मेजर्स टेकन बाय लॉर्ड कर्जन. One page, another page, what kind of long-term implication? Since he took so many measures, for example, Calcutta Corporation Act, Police Reform Commission, Ancient Monument Preservation Act, University Act, these are all the measure. Along with that is the partition of Bengal. Normally, an aspirant would commit the mistake, they would beat round the bush of the Swadeshi movement. If you simply write beat round the bush of Swadeshi movement, second part is correct, but you have not answered the first part. So the first part is you have to list out the policies and two lines explanation, because the question is this: evaluate the policies, so various policies. In that, one of the policy you can, to this question you can write Swadeshi movement. So this should be at least for 3/4 or one page. Next one page you should elaborate the Swadeshi movement, that is a long term. Police reform, University Act, just two lines, just to give a hint, that's enough. After that you come to the Swadeshi movement, then Swadeshi movement and the long term impact. In this, you can give more analytical point, because it was Curzon at first who discarded the suppressing the Muslim concept. There was normally British policy since 1857 revolt. What was the British policy after 1857 revolt towards Muslim and regarding 1857 revolt? The 1857 revolt was the conspiracy of Muslim. This is what the British consider. Since 1857 till the arrival of Curzon, all followed the repressive policy towards the Muslims. But it was Curzon who changed this mindset. Here you can write, that culmination is Swadeshi movement, that is the partition. Sorry, here is the partition of Bengal and led to the Swadeshi movement. So here is the partition of Bengal. This analysis you shall give it in the second part. Normally aspirant would write this alone, you would not be given score. In this, yes, this partition of Bengal had both plus and minus. What is the plus and long term of the national movement is, it is a eye opener for the Indian nationalist, especially for the Congress. Throughout the moderate period, no national major national movement. But with the partition of Bengal, anti-partition movement, Swadeshi movement, our national movement entered into new phase. This is one positive aspect. And it drew so many people, especially here only students and women, first time participated in large scale. So one positive aspect which everlasting in the national movement was, many people, it widened the base by including so many people into the national movement. And it is a one thing, gradually later become non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience, Quit India movement, August 15, 1947. This is one side of the long standing. At the same time, negative is also there. What is the negative is, it's a divide and rule policy, especially the creation of Bengal, eastern part of Bengal for Muslim majority. This side is the Hindu majority. So this has the long-term implication. So first thing, partition of Bengal. Second long-term implication is the separate electorate system for Muslim. Third long-term implication is the separate electorate system given to other. Fourth long-term implication is the partition of India. So partition of Bengal is the rehearsal to the partition of India. This is a long term. It's a rehearsal. That way you have to write. This is the exact thing of writing. Just two lines, note it down. Since it's a 10 mark question, no need to elaborate everything. And even I would say, even you can think beyond 1947. How I would say is, Lord Curzon partitioned Bengal province in 1905. 1947 partition of India. And what happened 1971, even you can write, it has the longest impact. That eastern part of Bengal later become East Pakistan, 1971 become Bangladesh. If you finish this answer, excellent. Normally, since it's a modern India question, an aspirant try to end with partition of India. But you can go one step ahead and even you can write of this also, that is creation, till the creation of Bangladesh. This is the way of approaching to this question. Question number 13. Since the decades of 1920s, it's very clear. Since the decades, they have given 1920s. But what is the end? End is up to 1947. Normally, decades means they try to finish up to 1930s. No. They never asked between 1920s to 1930. They asked the entire thing. Since the decades of 1920s to 1940s. Answer, end is open. Since the decades of 1920s, the national movement acquired various ideological strength and thereby expanded its social base. Even the same question in the case of Swadeshi movement also. Already Swadeshi movement added the social base by including the student as well as the women. Here, since 1920s, the national movement acquired various ideology. What kind of ideology here is? The first ideology is the Congress related. Normally, an aspirant would commit mistake of simply writing Congress ideology. For example, Gandhian phase. Here only Gandhian phase. They try to write civil disobedience movement, non-cooperation, quitting movement. Normally, this is one ideology. Don't simply answer this alone. Because question is national movement, not Congress movement. So, Gandhian phase. And all the Gandhian movement, NCM, CDM, a brief idea. Here, just non-cooperation. Here, civil disobedience. Here, complete quit India. It's a one thing. And second is, if you see why 1920s is 1917 Russian Revolution. Russian Revolution and the rise of socialist ideas. It's a second idea. Socialist ideas. Because of socialist idea, revolutionaries, HSRA, another is Congress Socialist Party. Because of HSRA, youngsters entered. So, social base is included. Even with the arrival of Gandhiji, social base was included. Social base. Peasant participated. First time peasant participated in the national movement during Gandhian phase. Here, youngsters participated. This is the second socialist base. And third is the revolutionary organization. So, here instigated the youngsters. So, youngsters started revolutionary. IRA, Indian Republican Army, Surya Sen. Even in the Bengal group, women also actively participated. It's a third. And fourth is, here also rise of the peasants. Peasants also. So many peasant movement. All India Kisan Sabha, UP Awadh Kisan Sabha, UP Kisan Sabha. That is also awakening. Not only that, along because of socialist idea, working class people also. Working class. This is the social base and ideology. Whenever ideology is widened, so many people will be included and social base. So this is what the thing. Two kind of way you can answer. One is, first you can write various ideologies. Various ideologies you can. Even in 1940s, an army, INA, it's a well-trained, that is Indian National Army. Initially, revolutionaries was not that much trained, but under Subhas, army concept. Right, these are all various ideologies. Women, workers, peasant, revolutionaries, socialist, another side. This is what the broad. How you can answer to this question is two way. One is you can write various ideology in 1.5 page. Various ideology. Next, you can write again the same ideology because of that social base. So because of this, women participated. Because of this, youngster participated. Because of this, likewise. This is one set of answer writing. Another set of answer writing is ideology. While mentioning about ideology, because of that participation, because of this ideology, these people participated. This is also one type. But the better thing is, since it's a very open-ended, it's very particular, not open-ended, particular, 1947, just the introduction, here itself you can provide various ideology. So this may be the second paragraph. And third paragraph onward, if you explain, if you provide a timeline and so-and-so based ideology, the evaluator immediately would appreciate, okay, the aspirant knew different ideologies. Previously, in 2018 or 17, this is the same. In that they have asked question 1920s to 1940s, what kind of various ideology? But there is 1920s to 30s or 40s, but here is 1920s till 1947, open-ended ideology. Even another one ideology you can add, here is the communalism also, because that communal based, the religious nationalism also, both liberal nationalism, otherwise extreme nationalism, communal based nationalism also, that's also one kind of ideology. So general explanation to this question, and you can answer in two ways.